So we'll use that current source heavily. Say, for the MOS circuit, we use current source bias. In the previous case, we used the tail current source, right? So we want to implement that current source. Say, we'll have some low-quality current source here, and then we use just a mirror. This is called the mirror, right? We will take this one. We can put just a simple resistor or simple diode. Diode is just something like that, right? Those diode for this current source. But we can use this one. We'll use this one constant GM, some sort of self-bias circuit. Okay, we'll talk about the implementation of this part later. And then, see, we'll just take out this current by using current mirror. For this current mirror, see, this current source and this NMOS diode will generate a DC voltage here, right? DC voltage. So for this transistor, even though it changes this output voltage, is a change. Output voltage changes in response to signal. So this is signal dependent, right? Signal dependent voltage. Vout is signal dependent. But its gate source voltage is a constant, right? So this current, IO, is it follows a constant VGS curve. So it's just something like that, okay? VD set. So this value is 1 over RO. So that output resistance is just lambda ID, right? This is ID is just DC level. So we'll see something like that. So for the good current source, for the very good current source, ideal current source just like that, right? We want constant current in spite of this Vout change. That's the ideal current source. That output resistance is infinite here, right? We want to increase output resistance. For that purpose, we need a cascode current source. Cascode current source. For the cascode current source, I think many of you are familiar. Say, we have one more stack. Two diodes in series. This is my cascode current source. So, this current source, this reference current source, and two diodes in series will generate two DC voltages there, right? They are DC voltages. And then, this I/O will be generated by this transistor because this I/O will be directly copied to this output node, right? The MOSFET which generates I/O is protected by this device. This is kind of some barrier protector. This is a protector. So it protects this voltage from Vout change. Its drain source voltage is almost constant. Gate source voltage is perfectly constant. Drain source voltage is just DC voltage minus VGS2, right? This is M2. So VGS2 doesn't change much Vout. See, my delta VGS2 is much smaller than this delta V out. Mostly this is something like GMRO, okay? Intrinsic voltage gain of N2. So VGS2 change is very small. So then this VDS1 is almost DC. For the VGS1, gate source voltage is perfectly DC. Drain source voltage is almost DC. So IO doesn't change in spite of VOUT changes. Okay? So IO is almost constant. So, yeah, it will generate a very good current source, something like that. It will generate. However, one drawback is for this operation, both M1 and M2 must remain in a saturation region. Then this is in strong inversion, yeah, something like that. Delta is 2VD set. Because for M1, you know, this is delta plus VTH. This is 2 delta plus 2 VTH. You know, just VGS is just a delta plus VTH, right? Another delta plus VTH. So, you know, this output voltage can go below VG2 by 1 threshold voltage. So, it should be larger than 2 delta plus 1 VTH, okay? To keep M1 and M2 in saturation. So, we have, we lost some voltage headroom. Now the next one is a wide swing cascade. We want to increase voltage headroom. So my Vout valid output range is just 2 delta instead of 2 delta plus VTH. Then how can I make that one? Say that one can be maintained similarly, but slight changes. Yeah, so this is a applied at the DC, and then this thing is connected like that. Yeah, this is my wide swing cascade. I need another bias source, something like that. So if I apply, say, 2 delta plus 1 VTH here, say, this voltage will be generated, this current source, and this MOS diode, okay? Then my Vout can be just 2 delta, and it still keep M1 and M2 in saturation, okay? Okay, let's try to, so you know that output resistance in both cases, small signal output resistance is, yeah, this is GM1, see, this is M1, RO1, RO2, okay, in both cases. So intrinsic voltage gain is larger than mostly 100, GMRO, okay, so this is pretty large. So let's look at the SPI simulation. Okay, let's look at one by one. Oh, how come? Okay. Then the first one is simple current mirror. You can see there is a VDDB, VDDB, this is 100 nanoamp current is here, and I have a MN1, which is, this is my B, and then this is something like that, And where is my output? Output is D, right? D. So this D is connected to where? Just a voltage source, right? Yeah, D. I apply drain source voltage. So this D is connected to a voltage source VDS. VDS sweeps from 0 to 3.3. Yeah, that's the simple current source. Second one is you can see this is a cascode current source. The third one is a wide swing cascode. How can I look at it? I just let's see. Yeah, I just eliminate it. No, just move it. No, just move it. All right, fine. Wide swing cascade. So this one, see, you can find the see two current sources here. See, all the same size. Oh, this thing is very small. So this B6 thing is, see, I have 100 nanoamp here. And then this B6 thing is here. And I have a very little 2x0.7 transistor to generate that cascade voltage here. So it's connected like that. And then I have another current source here, 100 nanoamp, which is IB3. So this is a B4 node. Okay. Then, see, I have something like that. They are connected together. This thing is connected there. You will see something like that here. Okay, actually, this is connected here, ground. So this is my VR. We'll sweep from 0 to DC, okay? We need some, say, this voltage is just 2 delta plus VTH. Delta is VDC, okay? We need some higher voltage. It should be large enough to keep M1 and M2 in saturation, okay? So let's look at the IOUT curve. Let's look at the SPICE. Simulate. Yeah, where is my DC? Oh yeah, this is current mirror. Yeah? Okay. Yeah, this one is a simple current mirror. So, and then this one is a cascade current source. This is a wide swing cascade. So let's see. So you can see simple current source, see this yellow one, it has a small output resistance, right? Not very good. Yeah, you can calculate the current, let's see, what's the output current source. See, if I change this voltage by 3 volt, yeah, that current changes like maybe around, what is this thing? 60 nanoamp, right? Say 3 volt divided by 60 nanoamp. What is it? 60 nanoamp, 60. Is it around 50K? I'm not sure exactly. So RO is not very large. But for the cascade one, you know, you can see very large output resistance. Let's enlarge it. So, you know, this red one is a cascade current source, see? Voltage headroom is reduced by, we cannot use below here. Okay, that's 2 delta plus 1 VTH. Which is what? Yeah, my voltage headroom is, I can use only 0.56 volt. My VOUT should be larger than 0.56 volt for cascode. Yeah, for the wide swing cascode for this VID3, yeah, my voltage headroom is increased significantly, right? This is around 0.18. However, the output resistance is reduced compared to cascode. This is because I couldn't increase that cascode voltage value, so some of M1 and M2 works close to, I mean at the boundary between triode and saturation. It doesn't go into full saturation region. Okay? Question? So maybe we can increase that, let's try to increase that, where is my code? Oh yeah, here. So if I reduce this thing, or if I increase this value like 3 micron L, then I will increase the voltage, right? Or maybe 4, what happens? So I want to increase that cascode voltage value. All right. Let's compare 2 and 3. Is it similar or slightly better? Maybe slightly. This wide swing cascode is still the arrow is smaller for the wide swing. Okay? Maybe it may improve a little bit. Okay, question? Nope.